Greetings viewers and subscribers. So in today's journey, we are back in Westmoreland. We'll be traveling from Lennox Bigwoods in the hills of Westmoreland. We are gonna go through Darlestan. Then we are gonna be heading down the hill towards Savlamar. Sit back, relax, and drive with me. So today, we have a few stories for you. But first up, we saw this comment as we were about to start this video. It's from Howie Blender. It says, Papaya News Link, I don't want to listen to your voice again. I was one of your Ardeen fans. But to be honest, I think you is not loyal to your fans. I have been listening to your blog from it started. I have wrote on your comment section telling you that I have a matter I want you to deal with. I even sent you 3 telephone numbers. When I write good comments, you compliment me. Now I need you to deal with a matter. You neglect me. I am not asking for money or no financial support. I think you are full of, well, you can see it on your screen. Howie, listen to me now. First up, I am not, I am not full of filth. I'm not laughing at you, but hear me. You see the comment section on my videos, I just respond to most of the comments by commenting. If it is that you want to contact me personally, my WhatsApp number is there. So Howie, send me a message, a WhatsApp message. You won't call me straight and get me on that number. The WhatsApp number is 876-458-9111. Anybody who want to contact me, that is the easiest way. I might not be able to respond right away, but I am going to respond, because that phone, sometimes when I go in, there are hundreds of messages on it. So I have to be going through and responding. So, Howie, no disrespect. Thanks for the support. And I remember seeing your comment, but you see, to go back and go through all of the comments, it's not gonna be easy to find your numbers. So send me a WhatsApp message to that number and I'll respond to you. All right, so let's get right into the stories. First up, we are learning that the Westmoreland police, they have seized an illegal weapon. This weapon was seized along Darling Street, Savlamar, in the parish of Westmoreland. Our information is that the Westmoreland police, acting on information, they went to our premises along Darling Street. This occurred on Monday, the 29th of June 2021, about 5 p.m. We are told that the police, they entered the premises, and at the back of a house, they searched between some building blocks, and a .38 revolver with the serial number intact was recovered by the police. No one was arrested in connection with this find. Congratulations to the Westmoreland police for recovering this firearm. In the next story, no, I'm not gonna stop reminding you to hit on the like button. If you are here, you are watching our videos, you appreciate our work, please hit on the thumbs up button. If you have not yet subscribed to the movement, hit on the subscribe button. Hit on the notification bell, then click all, so that you will be notified as soon as we have uploaded a new video. Now, last week Sunday, we brought you a story. Last week Sunday was Father's Day. It was about an incident that took place at Negril. On Friday, the 18th of June, 2021, about 10 p.m. It took place along the Norman Manley Boulevard in Negril, at a place named Rich Restaurant and Sports Bar. At the time, we had reported that the owner for the bar, we had not given his name at the time, but you are seeing his photograph on your screen right now. He is Andre Hines. He's otherwise called Jigga. He was 31 years old and a businessman of Norman Manley Boulevard in Westmoreland. Jigga, his birthday was Saturday the 19th of June 2021, so he was hosting his birthday party the night before, Friday the 18th of June. We are told that a number of persons were in attendance at this birthday party. This party was being hosted at Jigga's business place, Rich Restaurant and Sports Bar. The information at the time is that two motorcycles rode up with four men aboard, the rider and a pillion passenger on each motorcycle. The pillion passengers, they came off the motorcycle. They approached Jigga and opened gunfire at him. Jigga, he was hit multiple times in his head and his upper body. Two females who were nearby, one of them 21 years old and the other one 32 years old, they are both of Westmoreland addresses, they were also hit in the process. One of them received a bullet wound to her right thigh and the other one received a bullet wound to her right leg. The hoodlums, they then jumped back on the motorcycles and made good their escape. Jigga and the two ladies, they were rushed to the Savlamar Hospital, where the ladies, they were treated and subsequently released. But Jigga, he was admitted in a serious condition. At the time, we are told that when the police processed the crime scene, 12 9mm spent shells were recovered from the scene. Now, yesterday, Monday, the 28th of June 2021, we received information that Jigga, he had succumbed to his injuries. So these hoodlums, I am sure that they are now happy that Jigga is gone. Condolences to the family. May Jigga's soul rest in peace. And may his killers be found and brought to justice. Moving right along. In the Springmount area, there are two communities. Well, there are a lot of communities, but I will be concentrating on two communities. One of them is Dam Road. The other one is Coconut Walk. These two communities, young men from these communities, they used to go to each other's community, Dam Road and Coconut Walk. Now, sometime in early 2020, we are told that a young man from Dam Road, he collected some scamming money on behalf of a big lotto scam player from Coconut Walk. It is said that this young man, he failed to hand over the full amount of the money that he had collected. As a result, tension started brewing. Gunshots started firing. People started dying. Now, on the 31st of December 2020, New Year's Eve, we are told that some young men from Dam Road, they went into Coconut Walk. They fired several shots. This was an act of gun salute. You know, on New Year's Eve, some guys who have illegal guns or even legal guns, they fire their weapons. Well, these guys from Dam Road, they went to Coconut Walk, fired several shots as an act of gun salute. However, the top man, the top scammer in Coconut Walk, he didn't take this act kindly. He saw it as a means of disrespect, because according to him, these guys, they have no right to come into his territory, come fire up shots. We are told that an order was given. This order was given that some men from Dam Road should get dirt. So on Sunday, January 2, 2021, this was 2 days after the New Year's Eve incident, about some minutes after 1 p.m., bright middle day. Some men from the community of Dam Road, they were sitting at a shop in the community. Our information is that two men, now these two men are known by the persons from Dam Road. These two men, they approached the persons who were sitting in the shop from behind the shop. They already had guns in hand. They immediately opened fire and the patrons were in the shop. They then made good their escape on foot in the area. Like we said, these two hoodlums were known by the patrons who were in the shop. We are told that one of them is known as Doom and the other one is known as Dada. They were identified as persons from the Coconut Walk area. Now, when the shooting died down, it was revealed that five men were shot. Two of the men subsequently succumbed to their injuries. Kenroy Sinclair, he was 24 years old, and his last known occupation was that of a security officer. The other man who died was identified as Dean Reed. He was 44 years old. The three men who were shot, one of them is 32 years old. He's a laborer. The other one, 31 years old. He's a music producer. And the third one, he's 39 years old and he's a farmer. All of them are from St. James addresses. Now, Kenroy Sinclair, his mother is a police officer. They live nearby. In fact, the shop that Kenroy was shot in, we are told that it is operated by his uncle, who is also the police lady's brother. That is the information we are getting. And we, although it's from credible sources, we are not going to put our neck on the block for it. But that's how information comes. So somebody might have come in and say, I know so that go. But the substance of what we are saying cannot be disputed. Now, after this shooting, we are told that persons, they attempted to burn down a business place in Coconut Walk. This business place is owned by the mother of a top man in Coconut Walk. However, the persons were not successful. The tension between both areas was very tense, or is very tense. Since this shooting, there has been a lot of reprisal and counter-reprisal between both groups. Fast forward to Sunday, the 27th of June, 2021, about some minutes after 2 p.m., we are told that a number of persons, remember the first incident we told you about, it happened on a Sunday. This next incident we are going to tell you about happened also on a Sunday, about an hour apart. Some persons, mostly men, were sitting. We are not sure if it is the same shop, but that's what the information is saying, that it is the same shop where the first incident occurred. Some men, they were sitting at the shop. Now, there's a car wash and there's a shop. This car wash and shop, our information is that it is operated by the policewoman's brother and the deceased Kenroy Sinclair's uncle. These persons, they were in the vicinity of the car wash and shop when a gray Toyota Axio. Now, in yesterday's video, we had said Voxy. My apologies. But the motor car that they drove up in was a gray Toyota Axio motor car. The registration number for this car, we are told, is 3307JK. This car had four persons in it. Our information is that three of the persons who were in this car, they jumped out. They were armed with AK-47 rifles and 9mm pistol. The hoodlums, they then opened fire at the group of persons who were at this car wash. The owner for the car wash, who we told you is the police lady's brother, one of the men saw him. He was running away. The hoodlum chased this man and fired several shots at him, but he managed to escape unhurt. The police lady, she was nearby and saw what was happening. As a matter of fact, she went on her balcony and saw what was happening. When the hoodlums saw her, they immediately opened fire at her. She took evasive action and opened fire at these hoodlums. As a result, they ran for cover. They ran and jumped back into this Toyota Axio. These guys, you know, let me tell you something about them. You see, when them come and they are firing, they are not expecting fire to be returned at them. You see, when fire is returned at them, them turn idiots. In this case, it was the same thing. These guys, because the police lady was shooting at them, they all turned idiots. Them jump back in the car, drive away, but not for far. About 150 to 200 meters down the road, they collided in a Nissan motor car. Because guess what? All them mind, say gunshots still a fire at them. And like I said, them turn idiot. Them panic. So down the road, they crashed into a Nissan motor car. In this Nissan motor car were four adults, three males, one female, and two infants. When I say infants, I mean infants. One of them is under a year old, and the other one is about 2 years old. The hoodlums, they jumped out of the Toyota Axio that they were in, because due to the accident, it couldn't drive no further. They not only jumped out of the Toyota Axio, they pointed the gun in the car with the six persons in it, the four adults and the two infants, and indiscriminately opened fire in the car. Three persons who were in the car, they were shot. The lady, she's 24, she was shot in her back. One of the other passengers, 23 years old, he was shot in his right thigh. Another of the persons who were in the car, he's 21 years old, he received a bullet to his right elbow. The persons who were shot at the car wash were all males. One of them is 39 years old. He received a bullet wound to his abdomen. The other one, 44 years old, he received wounds to his thigh, his right foot, his left shoulder, and the right side of his jaw. Another one, he's in his mid-30s, he received bullet wounds to his left side. And the fourth one, he's in his mid-40s, he received bullet wounds to his buttocks. No. Our information is that when this crime scene was processed, 25 7.62 spent shells along with 15 9mm spent shells were recovered from the scene. Now, must I remind you, 7.62 spent shells is what is used in an AK-47 rifle. We had brought you a story yesterday about an incident at Browns Lane in the Granville police area of St. James. A man, 25 years old, named Carl Jackson, he was taken out in that incident. Sources are telling us that that man was also taken out by this said group of men. It should also be noted that similar weapons was used to take out that man, because a number of AK-47 spent shells as well as 9mm spent shells were recovered on that scene. Now, early yesterday morning, about 9 a.m., we are told that the police, they were alerted to the headless body of a man. This body was found behind the Janzal Primary School. We are told that it was clad in a black pants, white marina, and was not wearing any shoes. The head of this man who was found was discovered in a black plastic bag about 3/4 of a mile from where the headless body was found. We are getting information that this body that was found is of the man that you are now seeing on your screen. We have not yet confirmed whether or not it is so. If it is not, we'll be blurring out the photograph later on. But so far, we are being told from credible sources we are being told that that is the man who was found. We are also getting further information that this body that was found is connected to the incident that took place the day before at Dam Road Square. We won't say how we are being told it is connected as yet, because we are still seeking confirmation, but in tomorrow's video, we are gonna tell you who the headless person is, whether or not it is this man, and how it is connected, if it is connected, to the Dam Road incident. The mayhem continues. Blessed love, everybody.